The Bible is so much fun. I wish that other people would think the same thing. Not as many people as they should. Enjoy opening the Bible every day. In fact, I wish I could encourage everybody all the time. You know what one of the most enjoyable things in life is? Opening up your Bible and reading it and wondering, what's the revelation that I'm going to experience today? It's absolutely incredible. In fact, I posted something on Facebook today. If we read the Bible more than we read Facebook, we would be in a much better spot. In fact, that is so true. Open up your Bible and read it and hear what it has to say to you, because it will radically change your life. Every day you read it, there's some new revelation that makes you go, boom, no way. Today was that day for me. I opened up Ephesians chapter 1. We're in Ephesians. We're going to be studying it over the next couple weeks. And as I read Ephesians chapter 1, there was this aha moment for me where I went, no way, that is so cool. It wasn't that it was new information. It was just me seeing information that I had known already, to have it hit me at home right now in this moment in a way that it hadn't in a long time. In fact, I'd actually heard a pastor preach on this at one point. But that's the beauty of the Bible, is that every time you open it, it's new again. It is something that can change you in that moment. Even if you've heard it again and again and again, you may hear it differently in a way you never have before, which is why we repeat it, which is why we memorize it, which is why we put it into our minds, which is why we hide it in our hearts so that it may come out, that we may live it out, which is why we listen to the same stories again and again and again, and we hear the same things over and over and over again, because if you hear it differently this time because of your current context and situation, it will change your life. Yesterday, if you hadn't had a chance to watch that video, I'd recommend it, because I talked about the fact that right now we are put here for a purpose, and that purpose is to bring unity to all things, because we are revealing the mystery of Jesus to the whole world, so that when people see us, they will see him through us, and through us there will be unity as we wait for the day where he makes all things new. Well, guess what? There's a second purpose in our life. And it's laid out for us at Ephesians chapter 1, and it was the thing that today I went, no way. Verse 11, chapter 1, Ephesians. In him we were also chosen, having been predestined according to the plan of him who works out everything in conformity with the purpose of his will, in order that we, who were the first to put our hope in Christ, might be for the praise of his glory. Two purposes. First one, bring unity. Reveal the mystery of Christ in our lives so that when people see us, they see him through us, and they see the purpose of his will to be unified in all things, to bring unity to this world, which is what he's trying to accomplish. Second purpose being that we might be for the praise of his glory, that when we put our hope in Christ, when people see us, not only do they see him in us, but they also praise him for who he is. I heard a pastor put it this way when he preached on this passage. He said, does your life make it easier for people to follow God? Does your life, when they see all of who you are, when they see what you post on Facebook, when they see the way that you live, do you make it easier because of what you're doing for people to follow God? What a great challenge. What a great challenge for me, and what great challenge for us in this season, that when people see us, they see him through us, and it makes it easier for them to follow God. So let's analyze our lives. Let's look at what we're doing. The stuff that we post on Facebook, the way that we live within our communities, the opportunities we have to interact with people. Do we go into those situations going, is it gonna be easier for people to follow God once they see what I've done? When they see my life, do they wanna follow after him and not praise me, but praise him for what they see me doing? Man, what a great challenge. A boom moment for me today. And so I commit to doing that. As I go out from this moment right here, right now, I commit to make sure that when people see me, they see him through me, and they praise him for his glory, and that my life makes it easier for people to follow God. I challenge you, do the same, and I bet he'll work wonders in your life. Have a great day. See you tomorrow.